What is up, everyone? Maeglin here, and today I'm going to show you a replay in Iran, a 3-versus-3 match, of course. It is between the GOAT clan, Game of Thrones clan, which has now been changed, has changed his name to Boss clan, Brothers of Steel. Some interesting members are in this clan. Of course, most of you must have known most of those players. Here we've got Blinky, he is Lazar, and he's playing with dwarves. And another teammate of this clan is Necromancer, he's playing with Isengard. And of course, in the bottom left corner, we've got Ilúvatar, the third member of this clan. He's a dwarf as well, and he's starting with two battle wagons, very aggressive start for Ilúvatar. And let's see who we've got on the other side. We've got Kral Gomez, he is goblins. And we've got Erdem here, he is men. And let's see who their last teammate is. It's Darkness. Okay, this is a very interesting match. All players here are very experienced. In my opinion, right side is a little more experienced than the left side. But the armies are particularly interesting. I think right side has a slight advantage since it has goblins on their side, where the other side has two dwarves, which is obviously not the best option in 3-versus-3. But I think God Clan, which, like I told you, it's named Boss Clan right now. I think Boss Clan has played a lot of games together, and they pretty much know each other very well. So perhaps they will outplay their opponents by using better team play. You can see Necromancer here is rushing right away. He's trying to rush Erdem, of course, with his Lurch at level 2. Okay, I thought he would wait to reach him level 3 first, but no, he's going in right away. And here he's succeeding on crippling Erdem's Boromir. I'm not sure if he will manage to kill him. And here comes Ilúvatar's battle wagons as well. Of course, Kral Gomez is sending his spiderlings to help his teammate defend against battle wagons. Look at how effective spiderlings are against battle wagons. Spiderlings is the fastest unit of the game, and it can reach the battle wagons and of course destroy them. And here Necromancer is making a nice catch against Erdem. He managed to kill his Boromir, and he was going to target his Theoden as well. But Erdem's base is safe, in my opinion, since Kral Gomez helped a lot with his 3 units of spiderlings. Yet the fight is not over. Necromancer still has his Lurch and 1 unit of spearmen, and his Lurch Carnage will reload soon. So Erdem needs to deal with this problem very fast. Here comes Darkness, 2 wagons. As you can see, Darkness is playing with wagons as well, like Ilúvatar is doing, and I'm not sure where Blinky is. No, here he comes with his Gloint and 2, maybe 3 units of Spearmen. 3 units of Spearmen, and his Gloint is level 3, so they will manage to take down all these defense by Erdem. Very nice start for the left side, the Boss clan. And this is what I was telling you about. Look at how strong Lurch is after he has used his Carnage. But in the meantime, Kral Gomez is attacking Ilúvatar's base with his spiderlings. Of course, he will target the Forgeworks first in order to ensure that no more battle wagons will come. In the meantime, Blinky, who is Lazar, is doing very nice against Erdem. Remember, Erdem got pushed very hard early in the game. And here also, a very bad move by Erdem. He pushed his Theoden right in the middle. Of course, he knew that there were a lot of units to back him up, but very close call, as you can see. And here comes Necromancer's Lurch to finish the job, and here comes Erdem's heal. So if he has used heal, he doesn't have heal structure. His teammates are not using heal structure, so a very nice catch here by Blinky. With his Gloint, he managed to take down Erdem's fort. Very nice start for the left side. And here, look at this. A Necromancer, besides killing Theoden, he managed to save his Lurch as well. excellent player, Necromancer of course, knows how to handle each of his units and of course most importantly his heroes. Blinky here is going to lose his clone, but no matter, it doesn't matter, of course he has done his part of the job, which was to destroy Erdem's fortress. I'm not sure why those guys haven't used their heal action on Erdem's fortress. Look at that. Hell Darkness has already chosen heal. Kral Gomes has chosen his badge, of course, but Erdem had used his heal as well. So bad move there for considering their power points for the right side. And Blicky has used heal structure perhaps on his fortress. I'm not sure, I missed that. Perhaps he was attacked by battle wagons by Hell Darkness, and this is why he needed the rebuild. Look at that, even with rebuild his fortress is at 2/3 of its health. But doesn't matter now. Anyway, the left side obviously has a great advantage now that they have managed to take down Erdem's fortress. And look at that, Necromancer's Lurch is still alive, and of course he will die right now, but look at how much damage he managed to cause to those guys and how much trouble, of course. I'm surprised that those guys are leaving him. Yeah, those guys are signaling that Necromancer's Lurch is still there. They must not leave him, and here comes a heal. I'm not sure by whom, perhaps by Ilúvatar. Yeah, it was Ilúvatar's heal, a very nice cooperation here. And since Ilúvatar used his heal, his Necromancer's Lurch will be able to hit Hell Darkness Fortress right now, but no, he's targeting Erdem's stables, which perhaps might be the last building, but no, he has this heroic statue as well, so he will definitely manage to stay in the game for the time being. And Necromancer's Lurch was killed eventually, but a very nice play indeed. He managed to keep him alive for such a long time, and he obviously helped a lot attacking and giving trouble to his opponents. In the meantime, Kral Gomes is spamming lots of goblins, and he has already upgraded his spider pit and is producing some spider riders. Like I have told you many times, dwarves are excellent for attacking, but they are absolutely the worst in defense, and you can see that here. Kral Gomes only with 2, maybe 3 units of goblins, he's causing major damage to Blinky's structures. Blinky doesn't have a lot in his base, so I'm not sure if he will manage to defend it. And Necromancer's fort is also in a lot of trouble. Hell Darkness was helping a lot with his battle wagons, and of course Kral Gomes with some of his spiderlings. Look at that, more than half the health of Necromancer's fort is gone. And yeah, Necro is counter-attacking along with the help of... with no help at all, only with his units and of course the summon, the use of his 10 power point. He managed to take down Hell Darkness's fort and get him out of the game. As you can see here, he has been defeated, and I'm pretty sure that somewhere around here was Erdem's last buildings as well, so perhaps Erdem is out of the game. I can't see anywhere on the map any of his structures, so I will assume that Erdem has been defeated as well. So it's 3-1 now, and of course a done deal. A very easy game for the boss clan, but remember, those games have a lot of tactics involved. Boss clan wouldn't be able to succeed so fast in attacking their opponents if those guys hadn't worked together. You could see at the beginning all three of their armies was attacking in the middle, Erdem's fortress, and of course Erdem lost his fort barely, so perhaps even if one of those players wasn't attacking at the same place, perhaps those guys wouldn't have managed to take down Erdem's fortress, and then perhaps he would be looking at a totally different game. But since Erdem lost his fortress, then those guys, the left side, obviously had a great advantage. And in my opinion, the right team, Kral Gomez, Erdem and Darkness, did play a little bit selfishly. I think the only guy that helped his teammates was Kral Gomez with his spiderlings, of course. If you are goblins, you need to help your opponents, your teammates defend. But you could see Hell Darkness was playing on his own. He was attacking Blinky's fortress, and he did a pretty good job. He took down half the health of its fortress, but Blinky in the meantime managed to defend and also help his teammates attack. And I think this was the game changer here. Like I told you, how good a player is doesn't count that much in 3v3. It mostly counts how good you will cooperate with your teammates. And of course, to attack together and defend together at the same time. Of course, now it is impossible for Kral Gomez to hold back those armies. So a very small game, a very small game regarding time. But if you consider how much tactics were involved, and of course how much aggression was involved by the boss clan, I think we saw a pretty good game right here. And remember, those their opponents are very experienced players. It's very tough to win a game from those guys. Kral Gomez, Erdem, Hell Darkness, all amazing players. But here the boss clan managed to win this game simply by cooperating with each other. Very nice. So well done to boss clan. I hope you guys enjoyed this game. And yeah, I think I will have time to upload one more game before I leave. I think I'm going to show you a 2v2 match between Necromancer and Erdem versus Del Piero and Predator. There were 7 games played, and I think I'm going to show you it in a 2-part video. But yeah, for the time being, thanks you guys for watching, and see you around soon.